this example, we want to set up something similar to a Gantt chart. So you'll see here all dates. And we know that the start date and the end date for the land component is from the 1st of July to the 31st of July. So we want a conditional formatting to be built in, for example, in those two dates up to there, because that's land components, and then conditional formatting should disappear for that. But we also need to take into account that it's a bulk start and bulk end, internal start, internal ends, and these can overlap. So we need to be careful that we don't use a format type that can be either or. So a cell can either be one color or another. However, you can set up cells that are one color but shaded slightly differently and have borders that are different. So you can, by clever use of that, you can create something where, for example, you can see the green shading is the land, the lines are the bulk, and the internals are the red borders. So you can see more than one thing on one particular cell if they overlap. The solution to this example, now, because we're going to do a between here, it's useful to know that there's no function in Excel that does between. However, we can make use of an AND function to create a between. And because of the way we've set it up, this is going to require formulas. So let's just go up to here, so I'm highlighting all of those. Conditional formatting, new rule, use a formula. And what we need Excel to do is to check, is this bigger than or equal to the start date? And is that same one less than or equal to the end date? Because then we want it to shade. So in Excel, there's a function called AND. What we're going to say is look at that cell there, and keep in mind that I want to be able to copy it down. So I'm going to put my dollars on the 7. And is that either bigger than or equal to whatever you see in here? And in this case, I'm going to now tell it to stay on column B. So I put the dollar signs on B, put a comma. We tell it again, look at that on a 7. Is it less than or equal to whatever you see in the second one? Put the dollars on C. So hopefully that will do it. So we're saying, look here, is that bigger than or equal to what you see there and less than or equal to that? Let's format it, use a green shading. When I say OK, you can see that it looks like it's got it right. So if we just visually, up to the 29th of July, it's turned green. Here, when we're in August, it's no longer doing the land component. So that's the first component we've added. We're now going to add the bulk. As mentioned, I cannot now have another color because a cell can either be one or other color. It can't be both. So when I highlight this, we're pretty much going to do the same thing. Going to be a new rule, we're going to use a formula, we're going to use an AND formula, we're going to say look there, dollar signs only on the rows, is it bigger than or equal to? Now it must be the bulk, and put the dollar sign, so it's on the D, comma, dollar signs on the 7, is it less than or equal to whatever we see there, dollar signs on the E. When I format it, however, I can't use a fill because a cell can't be two different colors. So this time I'm going to use a style, and maybe we'll use these straight lines here. When I say OK and OK, you can now see that there is a slight overlap, which makes sense. Land is from the 1st to the 31st, but bulk starts a little bit earlier on the 15th. So there are overlaps. It allows for overlaps, but you can see that both at the same time. Lastly, we want to show internals, so I'm just going to highlight that area again. So again, pretty much exactly the same thing. New rule, formula equals and open bracket. Look at that, but only look at row 7. Is it bigger than and equal to what we see here? But only look at column F, comma, look at that, row 7 less than or equal to what's in there, column G, and when I formatted it, so now I've done a fill, I've done a pattern, so now we can go to the border, and maybe what I'll do is I'm going to have a red border, so I'm going to set it up that when we're in those dates, the border turns red, and you'll see it's now showing those items, and you can see the internals 1st of August to 30th of September, so all of those up to the 30th of September. Benefit of this now is if for whatever reason someone accidentally types 5th of July in here, the colors will change, and perhaps you'll know that it's impossible to do that before you've done the other step. So you can now use it and have some overlaps.